The Philippine government not keen on endorsing the findings of the House Quad Committee probe on the Duterte drug war to the International Criminal Court. Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin also reiterating the Philippines won't cooperate with the ICC investigation and won't rejoin the court. The Philippines left the tribunal in 2019 upon the orders of then-President Rodrigo Duterte because of its inquiry into alleged extrajudicial killings in the drug crackdown. The so-called House Quadcom has been investigating the drug war and POGOs. Duterte and his allies, Senators Ronald De La Rosa and Bongo, have been directly implicated in the killings. The panel is expected to release a partial committee report next week.
We will have to do a partial committee report recommending the conduct of a preliminary investigation or case build-up. Hindi lang sa DOJ, no, pati na rin siguro sa PNP para magkatulungan yung mga ahensya. Ano yung value ng revelation na yon at doon namin ipapasa yan sa mga ahensya.
The Philippine National Police forms a committee to investigate allegations cash rewards were given to police officers who killed drug suspects during the Duterte administration. The new Interior Secretary vows to go after officials who were once part of the scheme. Michael Deliso with the report.
Newly installed Interior and Local Government Secretary John Vic Remulla vows there will be no special treatment in the investigation into the involvement of former government officials in the Duterte administration's bloody anti-narcotics campaign.
There are no sacred cows in this institution and in this investigation. Anyone who is guilty, anyone who is found guilty, anyone will be treated like any other person, okay, they will be accorded no special treatment. They will be accorded no special privileges. Everyone will face the full consequence of the law.
Remulla called for a first command conference with top brass of the Philippine National Police at Camp Krami on Monday. Retired Police Colonel Rin Agarma last week implicated former President Rodrigo Duterte and his top aide, Senator Bongo, in orchestrating a cash reward system in the extrajudicial killings of drug suspects during his term. In her affidavit submitted to the House Quad Committee, Garma revealed information involving Duterte and Go regarding their roles in overseeing and coordinating the reward system for police officers who killed drug suspects. She said Duterte ordered her to help find a police officer to lead a national anti-drug task force replicating the Davao model, a system rewarding police for killings.
He needed someone capable of implementing the war on drugs on a national level, replicating the Davao model. The Davao model referred to the system involving payment and rewards.
Remulla said there are some steps that are already being undertaken by the PNP, including the investigation into the cold cases involving the killing of those who are allegedly in the drug watch list of the past administration. One of them was that of retired Police General Wesley Barayuga, who was gunned down in 2020 while he was then the Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office Board Secretary. Remulla said he will still wait for the full revelations and the conclusion of the investigation before taking any action.
I think with the testimony, some of the cold cases will be opened. But again, let us wait till the final hearings and final recommendations of Quadcom are done, and then subsequent actions will be taken.
PNP Chief General Romel Francisco Marbil said a committee has already been formed to look into Garma's revelations.
He asked the former chiefs to give a statement because it's already nasabi na kasi ni Colonel Garma na former chiefs are being informed regarding dun sa war on drugs. So we have to take their statements and say something about it para we know where we start sa investigation po natin.
Remulla gave the assurance that there will be no more extrajudicial killings in police operations against illegal drugs. Marbil reiterated the PNP's commitment to human rights and accountability and that it remains dedicated to upholding justice and restoring faith in its operations. Michael Deliso, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine Senator Bongo mulls filing a resolution to kickstart a parallel probe at the Senate into the Duterte administration's drug war. Guo also denied the accusations of retired police colonel Ruina Garma that the senator was working with his aide, Ermina Espino alias Muking, in the financial operations of the drug war. The senator's legal team eyeing to file charges against Garma.
Wala pong reward system na sinasabi nila ngayon. Masyado pong baseless accusation po ito. Wala po akong role, hindi ko po mandato ang operations ng war on drugs.
The Philippine Defense Chief remains skeptical of Beijing's sincerity to help craft a code of conduct in the South China Sea. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. earlier approved good faith discussions with China on adopting the long-delayed code. Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro doubts if China will show good faith in these discussions. But Teodoro says this will not deter the Philippines from taking part in a dialogue with China.
Committed sila sa dialogue, kaso sila lang naniniwala sa sinasabi nila, yan ang problema eh. Kung committed sila sa dialogue, yung kapanipaniwala naman. Committed din tayo sa dialogue, basta alam natin di tayo niloloko.
Hindi tayo sinasaktan.
Hindi tayo sinasaktan, di tayo niloloko.
A new survey shows most Filipinos will not favor pro-China candidates who are running in the 2025 Philippine midterm polls. 73% of respondents polled by Pulse Asia said they will not support candidates who align themselves with China. 23% are unsure if they will support them. 5% will still choose candidates with known leanings towards Beijing. The survey commissioned by the Strat-based ADR Institute also found a mere 1% of Filipinos believe China is a trusted partner of the Philippines. The U.S. topped the list of trusted partners with 79%, followed by Japan with 50%. Pulse Asia polled over 1,000 Filipinos from September 6 to 13. Four Filipino crewmen on board a vessel attacked by Houthi rebels this month, now back home. They are the second batch of the 21 Filipinos set for repatriation after their vessel, MV Minoan Courage, was attacked while traversing the Red Sea last October 1st. The first batch of seven seafarers arrived in the country on October 9. Meanwhile, the Migrant Workers Department says the remaining 10 seafarers are also expected to return home soon. The crewmen will receive assistance from the government and will undergo psychiatric evaluations. The Philippine government insists Filipinos involved in a surrogacy scheme in Cambodia were trafficking victims. This as they face possible criminal liability in the Southeast Asian country where surrogacy is illegal. 20 Filipino women were rescued in Cambodia last month, 13 of them pregnant. The Justice Department adds once they get back to the Philippines, they will be asked to cooperate with government's fight against human trafficking. The Philippine government is currently working on the repatriation of at least 7 of the Filipinos, while the 13 remaining who are pregnant may stay in Cambodia for further monitoring. Let's get an update now on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Lori De La Cruz. Good morning, Lori.
Good morning, Bettina, and all our viewers and listeners. Easterlies is affecting or prevailing over the eastern sections of Luzon and Visayas at this moment, and it's causing cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorms over Isabela, Aurora, and even Quezon Province. For Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we will have partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorms. And we don't have low pressure area or tropical cyclone monitoring or that is being monitored inside the Philippine area of responsibility. That's the latest from PAGASA. This is Lori De La Cruz.
Thank you very much for the update, Lori.